Chances are you've seen a news story or a webinar or read a white paper on CBD. And your patients may think it's a compound that could maybe make them high since it does come from the cannabis plant. But is this compound something that might be really helpful in a myriad of cases? Well, here's what the science says. And if you want to know more about CBD, make sure to like this video and comment below so you can become part of the conversation. So while only recently gaining attention in the media due to the Farm Bill being passed in late 2018 and subsequent changes in the law, the cultivation of hemp, just one variety of the cannabis plant, actually dates back thousands of years. Along with the increased media attention, we are now also seeing a growing body of research aimed at examining the effects of CBD, THC, and other phytocannabinoids in the treatment of several health conditions. And these include, but are not limited to, epilepsy, neuropathic and MS pain, cancer, and anxiety. When it comes to this powerful plant medicine, although much more research is anticipated in the future, to this date, there's been limited publications. So to further understand CBD and its therapeutic uses, let's first take a look at the endocannabinoid system, also known as the ECS. The ECS is found within the central and peripheral nervous systems, where it functions as a neuromodulator and biochemical communication system. It's made up of cannabinoid receptors, two of our own endocannabinoids, and enzymes. Our own endocannabinoids are actually lipids produced endogenously by the body and function as natural chemical messengers by interacting with the two cannabinoid receptors known as CB1 and CB2. CB1 receptors are found primarily in the brain. They can also be found in the lungs, kidney, liver, bones, heart, and reproductive organs. And in contrast, CB2 receptors are found primarily in the immune system, but also a little bit in the spleen, lungs, liver, bones, and muscle. So, what does the ECS and these cannabinoid receptors have to do with the CBD molecule? Well, in addition to our own endocannabinoids, there are two other types of cannabinoids that exist. Phytocannabinoids, found in cannabis and other plants, and then synthetic cannabinoids, which are manufactured in a laboratory. The cannabis plant actually contains over 100 different phytocannabinoids, and these of course include CBD and THC. These are the two most known phytocannabinoids. And while both of them can have effects on the body and the endocannabinoid system, it's important to understand that it's only the THC that possesses the psychoactive properties. So phytocannabinoids mimic the activity and the actions of our own endocannabinoids within the endocannabinoid system. And for this reason, it is believed that phytocannabinoids can help improve the function or tone of the ECS and regulate body functions and help to maintain homeostasis. And it's important to note that CBD extracts differ from full spectrum hemp products. Full spectrum hemp products contain CBD, THC, and several of the other cannabinoids, while the CBD products are made by isolating the CBD content from the cannabis plant, removing the THC and other cannabinoids. And it's also important to note that hemp-derived products contain less than 0.3% THC unless they're isolated CBD extracts. And full-spectrum hemp extracts, which are typically standardized to a specific quantity of CBD, also contain a combination of the other phytocannabinoids. So research is now pointing to the superior benefits of using full spectrum products due to the entourage effect, which is when the variety of phytocannabinoids act synergistically to elicit a therapeutic benefit. So you've decided to recommend CBD, and now you're wondering where to find a trusted source. Well, our friends at Natural Partners carry many of the top hemp-derived CBD brands. So shop for CBD products at naturalpartners.com today.